Hi everybody, welcome back to LSSL 5360, the Literature for Children class for the fall of 2018. I want to take some time in this screencast and perhaps a second one to go over the syllabus. There are some new items on the syllabus, including some new readings, and I want to make sure that everybody's clear on what it is you're supposed to do. The first page of the syllabus, surprise, surprise, is all the good information that you need to get in touch with me. There's my name, Terry Lassane. You'll see that right there. I'm now in the teacher education building in room 139. We call that the basement, the first floor. And our address has changed as well because we have moved from AB4 over to a new building. You have my office number here. That's the central office. You also have our fax number. And then this is the voicemail that goes into my office and it comes to me through voicemail to my cell phone. So if you need to leave a message, I will get that. These are the two Sam Houston emails from me. Either one or both will work. I do office hours on Tuesdays. I'm generally there by 8, leave about 4, sometimes 5. You can also arrange to have an appointment with me if you need. And I also, of course, can be in touch with you 24/7 because we're an online class. So that part I think is really good. Now, in terms of the syllabus, I'm not going to go through course description and idea objectives because I really do think you guys can read that on your own. I do want to point out some things in terms of the readings. The first is that your textbook for the course is an online textbook. It is available as a Google Doc. It is free and there is the link to it. We also have a link from Blackboard to your textbook. You're going to see some similarities if you've had 5385. You'll see some similarities because the genres don't shift, but some other things have. So it's going to look familiar for those of you who have already taken young adult literature. For required reading, these are the books that we'll all read together. You don't have to purchase them. You can probably check most of them out from your school library or from a public library. And some of them are short enough you can go to the bookstore and sit down and read it. I want to go through them pretty quickly. Oops, sorry about that, guys. My touch is a little heavy here this morning because I've made some changes here. So if you have an earlier syllabus like from last year, don't go by it because I have made some real changes. Derek Barnes' Crown, An Ode to a Fresh Cut is kind of a graphic novel format for younger readers, and it won 5 awards at this year's ALA Youth Media Award Ceremony. So you know you're going to be in for something special. Nonfiction is next with Georgia Bragg, How They Croaked, The Awful Ends of the Awfully Famous. It's the kind of nonfiction book that kids love about all those gory, gross kind of things. Dear Mr. Henshaw has been on my list for forever. I've been teaching this course for almost 40 years, and it's staying there because it's just an important book in the history of children's literature. It was published in 1983, and it's the first book that dealt with a main character whose parents were divorced. And so I want you to take a little bit of time to look at the history of this as well. Then we'll read Martina, the Beautiful Cockroach. It's available in English and in Espanol. It's also available in audio, and you can do any or all of those. The Legend of the Blue Bonnet by Tommy DePaula has always been on this list and will as long as I teach in Texas, which I think will be as long as I'm going to teach. It was inspired by a reading specialist in Huntsville, Texas, who kept telling Tommy, you need to write about the Blue Bonnet, you need to write about the Blue Bonnet, and he did. We're going to read the Newbery winner, The Graveyard Book by Neil Gaiman. You can also read the graphic novel version, which is kind of interesting because you'll still get the story. We'll read Nikki Giovanni's Rosa, beautiful illustrations by Brian Collier. We'll read It's So Amazing, which is sometimes called the sex book for young kids. You'll get a chance to read a graphic novel collection called Comics Squad. There are 2 and maybe 3 now in the series, and you may read any of them. This Is Not My Hat by John Klassen is a Caldecott winner. And in just a few words, but with lots and lots of illustrations, you get a great good humor of a book. You're going to read Cynthia Lord's Rules about the normal child, and put that in quotes, normal child, in a family that has a special needs child. He's autistic. We'll read nonfiction with Kadir Nelson's We Are the Ship. Gorgeous illustrations. This one won a Caldecott and a Coretta Scott King Award for illustration. Catherine Patterson's Bridge to Terabithia is a book that's been in print for a long time, as you can see, 1972, but it is still one that is loved by children and adults everywhere. You're going to read Jason Reynolds' For Everyone. It is a 2018 book. It's brand new. It is a very slim volume. You could probably read it in about 10 minutes. So if you can't find it in your libraries, go to the bookstore and take a look at it. Your time will be well worth it. We'll read another Newbery winner with Laura Amy Schlitz, Good Masters, Sweet Ladies. Part of the novel is in verse, and it takes us to a different time when people were masters and ladies and walked about, doffing hats and things like that. It's really interesting, and it's told from multiple points of view. We'll read Brian Selznick's The Invention of Hugo Cabret, the first book over 32 pages to win a Caldecott. And when I say over 32 pages, it's about 600 pages over 32 pages. We will read The King of All Picture Books, Where the Wild Things Are by Maurice Sendak. It is a pivotal book in the development of children's literature. We'll read Mirror, Mirror by Marilyn Singer. It is a collection of poetry about fairy tales. You can read them down from top to bottom, and then you can flip it and read it from bottom to top, and it becomes a different poem. I love Lane Smith's It's a Book. It's about a conversation between someone who loves a book and someone who loves his electronic book. So which will win, do you think? And finally, we'll look at Caldecott winner David Wiesner's The Three Pigs. Those are the 20 books we will all read in common. You're going to read now an additional 20 books, and for those, you have to read from these authors. I want to make sure that your time is really worthwhile here. So you're going to look at Kwame Alexander, Nick Bishop, Margarita Engel, Melissa Sweet, Mo Willems, Sharon Draper, Shannon Hale, Christopher Paul Curtis, Carmen Lomas-Garza, John Sheska, Jason Chin, Dan Santat, Nikki Grimes, Virginia Hamilton, Walter Dean Myers, Eric Carle, Ezra Jack Keats, Jess Keating, Faith Ringgold, and Grace Lynn. I tried for a balance here of male and female. I tried for as many multicultural as I could. I tried also for folks who write picture books versus chapter books versus a few novels. So you've got a real variety in there. And some of these are illustrators, and so they may have a different author on it. That's fine. You can still read that. So those are the 40 books so far that you're going to read for class. There's again lots and lots and lots of information here. You notice how fast I'm skimming through it, because that's not what's important. What's important is coming up in the next screencast, and those are the requirements for the course.